So when we do a burpee, we need to go into a squat before we put our hands down. There's a tendency to do a partial squat and then fold from the back and then put the hands down. So if we have limitation in our joints, there's a tendency to do that, to skip the full squat. So if we have tight hamstrings, which can affect the mobility at our hip joint, can affect the mobility at our knees. If our ankles are tight, ankle joints, then we won't be able to squat properly either. So when we can't squat properly, we find an easier way to get over our limitations. So it's important not to avoid our tight areas. And if you need to, you need to spend more time doing the exercises, which will help to mobilize your joints and not just throw yourself through these exercises. I'm still working on increasing my range of motion at my ankles and my hip joints. So when I first filmed myself doing the burpee, I noticed myself going basically just a partial squat, and I threw my hands down. I jumped back, did my push-up, jumped forward, and basically threw myself up from that point. So I'm trying to correct my own alignment. So you need to find the squat, put the hands down, jump back, do your push-up, jump forward, find your squat, and jump up. The other thing I wanted to point out is the placement of legs. Most of the time, we are taught to do squats in a wide stance like this. And I used to do this as well. I used to teach a lot of fitness and aerobics step classes. And those types of classes, we generally would start in a wide stance. And most of the exercises were in a wide stance, this type of thing, da-da-da-da-da. Step classes, you take it wide step. You might even step up and down. It's all big steps in a wide stance. So what happens is the muscles get stronger in that wide stance. We're basically reinforcing this alignment, this structure. So what I'd like to do is encourage you to gradually bring your legs together when you are doing your exercises. It's more unstable to do things with your legs together, and this is one of the reasons in group classes we tend to take the legs wide, because then we know people might not fall over. You're a little bit more stable in this position. So if you're always doing your squats in this position, you're reinforcing a wide position. When you walk, you don't walk with your legs wide apart, or hopefully you don't. You want to walk in parallel. For your body to function optimally, you need to have your joints lined up. All the bones in your feet should be lined up. And if we practice exercises out of alignment, that's reinforcing our body to hold on to that position when we are not exercising. So exercise is basically something that you want to support your skeleton in your everyday function. So when I do my burpees, I don't do my burpees in a wide squat. I don't squat like that. I'm gradually, over the course of this year, I have been bringing my legs into a close parallel because I want to reinforce a parallel alignment. So every time I do a squat, I'm going it down with feet in parallel. I'm trying to keep my inner thighs connected. So I squat down, I find the floor, jump back, still legs in parallel, push up, jump back to my parallel squat. From here, I jump up, land. So if I can focus on going slower, a little bit slower, and landing in the right position, I'm going to be better off than just using brute force and flying through these exercises, hoping that the speed is going to give me the results I'm looking for, which it won't. It might for a short term, but then that the effect of training out of alignment is going to negatively affect your skeleton and the way your muscles contract and support your joints. And that type of training can start leading to injury. So I'd rather do less well and be more consistent than beating myself up with excessive amounts of exercise. My timer is set for 8 rounds, 10 seconds of rest, followed immediately by 20 seconds of burpees. I'm going to focus on parallel alignment. I'm going to focus on my squat, trying to hinge at my hip joints, not rounding from my lower back. Here we go.